on a Sunday afternoon, and it had to have been mid-1974, Angela took me to catch a ride back to Norfolk, Virginia, the Navy base in Norfolk, Virginia. I met my ride at Beaver Run in 85. I remember it distinctly. And what had happened, it was a long weekend situation, and best I remember, Eisenhower Raines was his name. They called him Ike. Ike was a black man, 300 pounds, if he was a pound. Big old guy. First class petty officer. He was a fairly high ranking non-commissioned officer. And I remember he and I driving down from Norfolk in my car, and I carried him to Marietta, that's where he lived at the time, and come back home to where my parents lived in Lilburn, there at Beaver Run in 85, close by. And the deal was, Ike was going to pick me up and another guy on the way back to Norfolk on Sunday evening. We was going to drive through the night, because the ship was leaving the next morning. All right, so Angela took me up there, and I left and headed to Norfolk, Virginia, 550 miles, a good 10-hour drive. Up in Greenville, about dark, we started having car problems. And pulled over to the side of the interstate, and I can just about show you the spot. And there we were, me and the other guy, and I've been three of us, but I can't remember. So Ike's Grand Prix quit running on us. He had a pretty nice Pontiac Grand Prix. Pontiac's Grand Prix? Anybody remember those?
Yeah.
So Ike said, I bet, no cell phone, no GPS. So here's Ike getting out of the car in a thunderstorm. Now, I'm not making this up. In a thunderstorm coming up. So there's Ike walking down the interstate and gets to a phone, obviously. And, gosh, I don't remember the details, but we ended up at the house of a man as a mechanic that just got home from church. And he said, your fuel filters stopped up going into the carburetor. Remember carburetors?
Oh, yeah.
He said, there ain't nothing I can do. Parts store's not open. He gave us a pair of pliers. He said, if it does it again, take that fuel filter out. It's easy to get to. Sure enough, that fixed the problem. Thinking back, that man who just got home from church might have prayed for us. He said, might have prayed for us. Going on up 85, Charlotte. Started having problems again. Same thing. They were just not a convenient place to get off the interstate. To pull over to the emergency lane. In Greenville, we just pulled over to the emergency lane. In Charlotte, there wasn't a convenient place for whatever reason. So we got off the interstate. Mistake. Got off the interstate. Got lost. Got the car running again. Got lost. No GPS. By then it had to have been 10 o'clock. Or maybe a little later. We eventually found our way back to the interstate. We made it to Norfolk, Virginia. I think I've told y'all this part before. I'm not kidding. Just as the ship, the tugboats were tied up to it, the gangplank was pulled up, said probably, I'll park the car, y'all get out and tell them the way. Praise God. Ike was highly respected, a non-commissioned officer. If it had been me and them other two guys, they probably left us and we'd have missed shift movement and all of that kind of stuff. But they waited on Ike, and we got on there. Now, that's a whole story in itself, but I want to go back to that part in Charlotte where we got lost. I don't know, I probably couldn't repeat the words we said when we realized we were lost, you know. But I'm sure somebody said to the effect, you know what, we're lost. You know, again, three or four sailors, it might have been a little saltier than that, but, you know, we're lost. We're lost. you know, we did, as I told you, we did find our way back to the interstate and made it to our final destination. I already told you that part. You know, we were able to get found or unlost, whatever you want to, however you want to describe it, you know. We got back on track. Now, you may have had, if I told, there's probably been, everybody in here at some time or another has been physically lost. You know, this is, again, going back before GPS. I mean, you can get lost with GPS. I just still, personally, I just don't trust them. You know, okay. If you're going anywhere, I think it's crazy just not to meet. I look at a map. If I've never been there before, I look at a map. And that GPS better be following the route I have in my mind to get me there. You know where GPS is good? I'm getting off the track here. You're at the place you want to go. And he said, I wonder if there's a Red Lobster here. I wonder if there's a Chili's here. That's where I use GPS. You know. Where's Walmart? Where's fuel? That's what, to me, that's what GPS is good for. You don't know. It's going to ride around. But anyway, I digress. You know, we've all probably had those experiences, similar experiences, and you might have said something like, oh my God, I'm lost. Oh my God, we're lost. And your wife or significant other says, yeah, we really are, you know. Yeah, and you shouldn't have, and it's always, yeah, and if you had listened to me, or if you hadn't done it went that way, or if you'd looked at the map, we wouldn't be lost. But oh my God, I'm lost. Now, I hope you see where this is going. This cuts two ways. Bill Burnham, pastor that friend of mine, actually married both of my children. He's preached here one time. Harry knows him very well. He married both of my children, baptized both of my children. Bill used to say this frequently, as lost as a ball in high weeds. That stuck with me. That's one of the things I remember. You know, that person is as lost as a ball in high weeds. Now, you know, we growing up, we played baseball. And where we played, if you hit a home run, you had to hunt for the ball. It went into the woods. You know, that was the home run mark. You hit it in the woods, you got a home run. You know, lost as a ball in high weeds. You know, a person can be physically lost, like we were up there in Charlotte, like seeing, probably got other instances where people have been lost. You could be physically lost and spiritually lost. It's easy to realize when you're physically lost, isn't it? You know, you're in unfamiliar territory. I mean, like, you look, oh my God, I'm lost. We're lost. It's easy to know that. You know you're not where you're supposed to be. It's not so easy to know when you're spiritually lost. You know, and Connie's already talked about it, but we'll read that scripture again. Zacchaeus seemed to know that he was lost. Now, I also want you to put this in context. You know, Connie's already talked about it. You know, Zacchaeus worked for the IRS. The Roman equivalent of the IRS. Terry knows I'm giving him a hard time. He was a tax collector, and they were not held in high regard because they did pocket a little bit for themselves. They took a commission, probably. That's the way the system was. I don't think, you know, they termed them as sinners, so the Pharisees did. It's not a sin to collect taxes by any shape, form, or fashion. It is a sin to collect more than it's supposed to be collected. But anyway, let's pick up in this story with Zacchaeus in Luke chapter 19. I'm going to read verses 1 through 10, but I'm going to stop after 4 for a second. And he, Jesus, entered and passing through Jericho. And behold, there was a man called by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax gatherer, and he was rich. And as he was trying to see who Jesus was, he was unable because of the crowd, for he was a small stature. He was a short guy. He ran ahead, climbing up into a sycamore tree in order to see him, for he was about to pass through that way. Let's stop there a second. Jesus was passing through Jericho. And a short tax man named Zacchaeus wanted to see Jesus. Looking at this, you see his urgency. So here's a guy that's got it made. He's rich. But there's something about Jesus that he wants to see. He knows he can't see over the tops of everybody else. So he's going to climb up a tree to get a better look. If you read on in Luke, one of the next big events, this is right before what we call Palm Sunday, before Jesus is triumphing in entry into Jerusalem. So Jesus' ministry, 3-year ministry roughly, on this earth was coming to a conclusion. I mean, Jesus might have been a month, 2 weeks away from the cross, roughly, or maybe a little less than that. Let's pick it back up in verse 5. And when he came to the place, he looks up and said to him, Zacchaeus, hurry and come down, for today I must stay at your house. He hurried and came down and received him gladly. When he saw it, they all began to grumble, saying, he, all, meaning the Pharisees and scribes and Sadducees, the ones that are always pestering Jesus, he has gone to be the guest of a man who is a sinner. And Zacchaeus stopped and said to the Lord, Behold, Lord, half of my possessions I will give to the poor. And if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I will give back 4 times as much. And Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house, because he too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and save that which was lost. That's amen. That is why Jesus came. To seek and save the lost. Jesus comes and tells Zacchaeus to come down. He wants to eat supper with him. Zacchaeus repents. You know, Jesus didn't have to, I don't see a give and take about repentance in there. Zacchaeus already felt something. Something wasn't right. Zacchaeus knew it. And I'm reading that too, that it doesn't say that he defrauded, but Zacchaeus says, if I did, now he was paid well to do what he did. He said, if I did defraud somebody, I'll give them back more. I'll pay them back four times. Again, Jesus says, today salvation has come to you. I have come to seek and to save the lost. Now, I don't know if we don't see it in here. I don't know what Zacchaeus said. We don't know if he said, oh my God, I'm lost. But he was desperately seeking Jesus. There's no way that you can read this and not know. Here's just think about this. A man of means, he wanted to see Jesus bad. He knew he was going to be ostracized by his fellow tax gatherers. Why in the world, Jesus, is like, by that time, people, the followers loved him. Those that didn't hated him. They were trying to get rid of him. There was no in-between by that time in the ministry of Christ. So Zacchaeus knew he was going out on a limb, so to speak. Literally out on a limb, as I said. But I don't know if he said that, what he said, but he desperately wanted to see Jesus. Jesus wanted to visit with Zacchaeus because he knew Zacchaeus was lost, didn't he? He knew Zacchaeus was spiritually lost. He wasn't physically lost. And I think Zacchaeus knew himself he was lost. I think he did. I really think he did. it's not the first time Jesus talked about seeking and saving the lost. If you go back to chapter 15, he has three parables where he talks about somebody looking for something that's physically lost. And the meaning is obviously spiritually lost. The lost sheep. Jesus said, what good shepherd is not going to go out and look? If he's got 100 sheep, there's one lost, he's going to go out and look for that one sheep. And then he finds that one sheep and he greatly rejoices. The lost coin. How much? Well, if you lose a quarter, you might not know it. Rarely we're going to say, oh my God, I lost a quarter. Where is it? If you know you lost a dollar, you gonna go look for it? I admit I would.
Yeah.
If I lost a 20, I'd go look for it. Obviously, you go higher, 50. Say it like this, but I'm fond of 50s. Not because 220s and a 10 won't do the same thing. I don't like a lot of wad bills in the wad. When I get cash out of the bank, Angela's like, I'm afraid I'm going to get mixed up with a 20. And when I don't have these on, sometimes that might happen. But if I lose a 50, a 20, I'm going to look for it. The point is, this woman with a lost coin, we get the feeling that she her losing that coin was going to make a big difference in her ability to live. That's the point of this. She desperately looked and sweeping up She knew she had 10 coins, and I think she said then she lost one. And she finds it. She rejoices. The lost son. Now we know this is the prodigal son. You know, he went off and got himself lost. Well, he probably knew where he was at physically, but he went off into the world and got himself lost. Lost in all the sin and debauchery that the world can give. He got lost into that. And he realizes, oh my God, I'm lost. I think he can read into that, oh my God, I'm spiritually lost in the lost son, the prodigal son. He comes home, we know that story. And I think the father says, the one who was lost has been found. Again, great rejoicing. You know, you and I are that lost sheep, that lost coin, that lost son or daughter, that lost person. And Jesus is the one seeking the lost. I've been physically lost and was able to get myself found. I've been lost. I don't remember. I wasn't much of a praying person back then. I might have said a prayer. I don't know, don't remember. But I had a situation where I've been lost. And I said, oh my God, I'm lost. Lord, help me. Help me, Lord. Find my way back. And I may be lost again, physically lost. You know what? I'll pray quickly. I'll pray quickly. But I was once spiritually lost. I was spiritually lost. I was born spiritually lost. Jesus sought me, found me, and saved me.
Amen.
I don't remember saying, oh my God, I'm lost. At Sardis Baptist Church Bible School when I was 14. But I think subconsciously, I knew it was. If you are physically lost, you want someone to find you, correct? Is there anybody that wants to be physically lost and stay lost? Anybody? Nobody. Now you know what the next question is going to be, especially if you heard me. Why wouldn't you want the same thing if you're spiritually lost? Why wouldn't you? There's going to be a part two to this next Sunday. It's a simple plan. Now Jesus finds you. You know, Zacchaeus, which is Zacchaeus? Zacchaeus didn't have to give his life to Christ. Oh, I see him. That's all. I got his autograph. That's it. You can be physically lost. Yeah, woohoo, yeah, I found it. Jesus is seeking, still seeking to save the lost. He can come and knock on the door of your heart. And you say, I'm okay. I'm not really spiritually lost. But you may say, oh my God,